Alright, this intro, it's a little fucked and weird, whatever. Raindrop, drop top, he's a spitting guns, that's K-pop. California style that you can't stop. Can't bear what I do to your golden locks. Keep my girl tied up with golden locks. My name is SoCal Steez, throw your girl with so much ease. And yes, I aim the fucking please. California West Coast is what I'm fucking rat. Been trying to get to the top level, you better get to stepping. So much Steez, they ain't trying to take me out. I'm watching Freaks and Geeks on Netflix, that's why Judd Apatow. DMX, you out the game, cause this for Rough Riders. Why do I keep making videos? Well shit, it's for the subscribers. Oh, let's fucking go, I can fucking mumble rap. But I'm not a rapper. And don't fucking worry, my chair is fine. Oh, peep that horn though. What is up you guys, it is SoCal Steez. Welcome to today's video. Today, we are going to be reacting to Migos' brand new album, Culture. I'm pretty stoked to listen to it. I'm bipolar on Migos, as stated in my previous video about when I reacted to the t-shirt video, which is I thought was pretty fucking dope. But yeah, when it comes to Migos, they're probably my favorite in mumble rap. I absolutely hate mumble rappers. I don't understand what the fuck you're saying. The beats are banging, kinda. But Migos, hands down, they're the best at it. Their production's on point. It's just weird. You can feel their chemistry. They're vibing off of one another. And I like that about them, even though some of the lyrics are, they tend to be pretty basic. I'm not looking for anything lyrically too deep, but hopefully I get some dope-ass bangers on this album. I don't know, who knows? But either way, if you guys like the video, hit the thumbs up, comment down below what your thoughts are on the project, what you guys want me to react to next. Social media down in the description, so feel free to follow me on my Snapchat, Instagram, and Twitter. And don't forget to hit subscribe so you guys don't miss out on any more content. Let's check out this album. Let's see if this shit bumps! Track 1, Culture, featuring DJ Khaled. Shit, alright, here we go.
Play themselves. This the intro.
Of course.
Fuck boys, that boy bow down.
Still up in the coop, my phone's
gone.
I got ass by bone, bone. Up in that cone, spin the Eminem and Jones, Jones. Took a trip to Cancun, Cancun,
See, the thing I like about Migos, even though they're labeled as mumble rappers, I know what the fuck they're saying, you know?
Nigga putting on the act.
I thought that was a good intro, you know, quality production, you know, Migos knows how to, I like the beats they always choose, their flows, it's always that you know, but like, Migos, I'd rather hear it from Migos than any other rapper, to be quite honest. Migos, there's something special and unique to them, like, I can't pinpoint it. Track 2's t-shirt, I already reacted to the music video. I'll put snippets right now. If you guys want to watch that full video, link will be in the description down below. Hope you guys enjoy. You guys, let's have a serious talk. Real talk. Track 3, Call Casting. I know this is one of their singles. I personally didn't want to watch it. They were dropping too much shit. All right, let's go.
Buddha bless this beat.
That's a fool now,
Chopsticks.
Nah.
Nah. Trap turns
back.
I beat the pot with a passion. Beat it up. 100 echoes on the mansion. I dab in the latest fashion. Hit it up. Bitches need a call casting. Yeah. Gold on my nigga black. Black. Man, no shanks, rib shack. Hit it up. Run the plug, give me tax. Sack. Sit the lean and relax.
Hold up, you guys. This fucking sucks. Not the track. I'm looking outside and it's fucking snowing. Ah. All right, let's proceed. Overall, I thought the track was pretty decent, you know. I don't think there's going to be like an absolutely stellar track, but they're decent quality tracks. They're not bad. But, you know, I don't mind listening to it if it's in the club or if it's just bumping in the car. Fuck yeah, but like, will I directly go to it? Probably not, but that's not to bash on the song. It's not, you know, let's go to the next track. Ah, shit. Track 4, Bad and Bougie, featuring Lil Uzi Vert. Do we really need to react to this?
Hey! Raindrops. Trip. Drop top, smoking on. End up dope in the crock pot, pot. We came from nothing to something, nigga. Hey! I don't trust nobody, good to.
What can I say about the song? At first I was annoyed, but the more you listen to it, the more it gets stuck on your head, the more infectious it gets, and then it's just those songs that you hate to love, and you love to hate, but deep down in your heart, you know you fucking love it. Track 5! Get Right With Ya! Oh! I'm very curious to see how this beat is played out right now.
Hold up. Right with you, I'ma get right with you. Bad bitches, fuck up, then dismiss. Make a million, then I make it twice. Bought the rape and had the ceiling light. I like a bitch with some cellulite.
Not gonna lie, not really a fan of the song. It was very underwhelming. I thought the beat would have been better. The flows, I will say this, it does get very repetitive. Like, I think they do it very well, but I can only handle it in chunks, you know. A whole album of it, that's asking a little bit too much, but going into Amigos project, I knew that, but it's just a small gripe about it, but you know, next track, track 6, Slippery, featuring Gucci Mane. Okay!
Just a starter. Pop, purple, just a warm up. Two cups, drink. I heard your bitch, she got that water. Splash. Set up top, fuck niggas on my radar. Watch. Watch him crack a die, hunter. Turn him to some gator shots. Cause I got you the call, now she can't get over me. Hey. She wanna dose me. Just hop in the ghost with me. Just a starter.
I fuck with this track, dude. They're spitting. Ah, they're going hard.
Please, man. I'm up, don't believe me, but they feelings. My bitches, I spoil them like they chillin', so persistent.
I love that track, dude. Production, bangs, like that. I would love, this bumps in the fucking whip, dude. Everything about it was great. Nothing to knock on the song, to be quite honest. Even Gucci Mane, I thought he did pretty well. And, note to Gucci Mane, stop dropping a decade's worth of music into 6 fucking months, dude. Spread your shit out. Wait it out. Stop dropping album after album after album. Relax. Take a vacation, dude. Enjoy your fucking life. Track 7, Big on Big. Oh.
Big on Big. Big on Big.
I like how they're using a lot of pianos, like pieces, in their tracks. I noticed.
If you having paper and I'm having paper, how you go big on Big? If I got the drinker when you got the scene, how you go big on Big? Just a 5, my bitch is a 10, how you go big on Big?
I thought the track was pretty sweet. The production made it very, like, I know the track's big on big, but like it felt fucking huge, dude. Like, it's just, that's what I got from the production. It's like very open aired and it's fucking massive, it's huge. And dude, their flows are on point, dude. Like, I don't know, you think you get annoyed by it with a full album, but for them, it's a highlight, to be quite honest. Track 8, What the Price. Ooh, electric guitars? What? This kind of reminds me of a Travis Scott song, to be quite honest, on Rodeo.
What's the price?
Oh.
Prices going up. What's the price? Prices going up. Prices. Hold on. Price. Yeah. Outside with my people. Pink slip for the ride. But what's in the trunk? It's illegal. Came going up. Hold on.
Oh, this fucking beat, dude. That might be, it possibly could be the best track on the album so far, aside from T-Shirt. Dude, that's probably one of their most ambitious tracks I've ever heard by them, production-wise. Like, that was absolutely fucking stellar, dude. And their rapping was on point, son. Was dope. Dope shit. Why can't all mumble rappers do this? They can't. They shallent. I don't even know if that's a word, but they shallent. But man, Migos, they're on a fucking level. Another level, dude. Another one. Speaking of tracks, another one. Track 9, Brown Paper Bag, Lego.
Pussy. Fuck all these niggas. Yeah. Brown
paper
bag, man. Cash.
Smashing your home. Wait. No. Who can make, like, I can't think of anyone that can just start off as brown paper bag. Like, who starts a track like that? That's, alright.
Calling me dad. Smack. Cupping the bitch when she fucking you going outside. Sad. I had a dream in the pool, I was swimming through cash. That's your man, bitch, I will fuck, click, 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 shooting out strong my wrist. Money is over a bitch. Money.
I thought the track was okay. You know, not. It was probably like the other track. It's just a throwaway track for me. They could have slimmed it down to 11 tracks, those two tracks. Production was pretty decent. Quavo was dope on the track. Quavo was my favorite part of the track, to be quite honest. And yeah, I don't know, it was probably me being retarded and all, but every time they said brown paper bag, I just kept thinking of a lunch bag that I brought to school in my elementary days via early 2000s. But you know, oh well. Track 10, Dids, featuring 2 Chainz, Titty Boy.
You niggas in trouble.
Oh. I have this like epic badass feeling right now with this intro. I feel like I'm in trouble. Oh. Wait, let me. Oh, hang on. Hold up. I was not ready for that drop. I was. Let me get a drop of this water, though.
Fresh out the bed. Count out the dead. Fresh out the bed. Count out the dead. Fresh out. Out of the bed. Count out the rapping. I be trapping. Not be coming. You niggas in trouble. Now for you real, niggas in trouble. My money long like you niggas in trouble. The bed. Pop out the bed and I'm counting no faces. I jump out the whip and no bitches. I'm fighting no 20s.
Oh my god.
I keep the bag on my brother, my partner. Don't fuck with no strangers. They trying to get famous.
How is that track not a single? I do not understand. How is that track not a single? Oh my god. That was. Oh. That production just bangs. On all levels, dude. And that ending, I don't know who it was. Was it Takeoff or Set Off? I don't know their names. I only know Quavo and Takeoff. I don't know the other. I'm sorry. Dude, whoever was that last dude, that last verse was fucking killer. I don't think it was 2 Chainz. But, dude, that. Oh, my lord. He went fucking ham. He did a Childish Gambino. He killed Beef and went ham, dude. Oh my lord, that track was amazing. Track 11, All Ass. I mean, this is like a stripper track that should be played in strip clubs. All right, here we go. Oh yeah, this definitely should be played in strip clubs. All right. Oh yeah.
Walking out with bags at the store. Fast stripper girl shaking her ass. I'm walking out with bags at the store. Fast stripper girl shaking. If you wanna fall, let's get it.
This is probably a track I've been looking forward to the most. Track 12, Kelly Price featuring Travis Scott. Probably, you know, that for obvious reasons, right? It's La Flame. They got La Flair and La Flame on the same album, dude. That's pretty dope.
Always keep some bitches on the side, yeah. Don't stand too close, my diamonds gonna bite. Why round, don't ride, why round, get right, get rich, good night. Straight up, treat the Bentley truck like a giant. Got the red and blues on my eyes. Got lethal, nice, lethal, dark. My bitch got lethal.
gon' suck me dry until we land. Yeah. I'ma call on Scar like, what's the plans?
Even rock. Track 13, last and final track, Out Your Way. I like the sound of it as of right now. It's very fitting to end the track. You will
understand. All this pain we can live through it. It's called success.
You always going out your way.
You are out your way, so out your way. They're going out your way, they can't lose.
Alright, now, I forgot to talk about track 12, Kelly Price. I thought this track was pretty dope, honestly. Travis Scott, he killed a sting. I feel like Migos, Travis Scott, and Young Thug, their chemistry together, even though Young Thug's not in track, I'm just talking about overall when they do feature one another, their chemistry is on fucking point, dude. It's on another level. Another one, yes. But for real, though, their chemistry, it's just, it's untouchable, dude. I personally like it when they collab. Their tracks are tend to be fucking dope, dude. But the last and final track, Out Your Way, I thought it was a fitting end, you know. Smooth vibes, pretty decent banger. My overall thoughts on the album, I liked it a good amount, you know. Some tracks were throwaways, Brown Paper Bag. I think the other one was Get Right With Ya. But overall, the tracks are decent. There's pretty dope-ass bangers. Some tracks are pretty standout. You know, T-Shirt, Bad and Bougie, Deads, even Kelly Price, I'm big on big, but overall, for me, it's hard to get over the like that repetitive flow, but Migos, they pull it out their ass. I thought it was pretty decent to listen to, but I rather have this album in chunks rather than a whole. You know, it's just something on a shuffle when I just jam in the car with friends and whatnot. But overall, this album was pretty dope. If you're a Migos fan or you like mumble rap, this is definitely the way to go. If you like rap in general, I definitely recommend this. This is pretty, it's a cool listen, you know. Nothing to really bash on it, you know. It's 13 tracks, it's around an hour, so it's not too long. But yeah, if you guys like the video, hit the thumbs up, comment down below what your thoughts are on the album, what you guys want me to react to next, social media down in the description, so feel free to follow me on my Snapchat, Instagram, and Twitter. And don't forget to hit subscribe so you guys don't miss out on any more content. Just want to say thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Stay safe, stay gold, and deuces. I absolutely hate driving in Ohio, dude. For sure, there's major differences between driving in Ohio and driving in California. What I learned, what I realized, is that in Ohio, the drivers, they're way more patient.